bouncy killer. I found it.
Chilling, you know. Chilling.
So is this where you did most of your album, My Experience?
Yeah.
Mixing Love?
Particularly My Experience. That album, most of it has been manufactured here and mixed, rhythm laid and everything, because at the time we broke up with Jammies, we never really had no choice. We had to just find some home. So I had my friends here, Bulby and Sly and Red Rose, so I just came in and they all helped, and it's a bomb.
Yeah. We were talking outside about how it's so hard to break into this industry. And, you know, for everyone, all the DJs that want to get into it, how did you get your whole start in it and got, you know, that you've gotten to the level that you're at now?
Oh, well, it's really hard, you know, but you have to just have enough self-confidence and believe and put out the best. You know, you have to put out. First song I recorded was a song speaking against guns. Then, yeah, that song, they released that song, it never get too much of credit that I look forward to. So anyway, I did the next one called Dipping. So that the party song. Because, you know, Jamaicans like to stow away to foreign and never return with anything and whatever. So I did the party song, and that one get a little response on the radio. So I get more courage, and I never stop. So it was accidentally I was coming from school in 1986 when I get shot. So I made up a song from that time called Copper Shot, because I was accidentally shot in political fiction. That's why I DJ so much against political fiction and all that.
Why do you think that some artists do so well speaking out against guns and violence, and then others do so well talking about it, you know, about doing it?
Yeah, because you had people out there who love when you speak about the guns. They support it because they are the ones who go around and use the guns. So it's like they love it. So as I was saying, I was accidentally shot. So I make a song called Copper Shot. But the first song I record was a song speaking against guns. So when I do that song and do Dip Him, and I see no response I was looking forward to, I said, seems as if I'm doing the wrong concept. So I said, okay, let's do that Rude Boy song, because it was about 1992 when Ninja Man had the place under his influence. So, you know, everyone is infested with Rude Boy gangster lyrics. So I did the song called From Me Pop Out Me Gun Blood I Go Run, like a river Jordan I come down. From Me Pop Out Me Gun Holy Pop Blood I Go Run, X amount of people life I go down. Copper Shot, it went as a bomb. So they never really want that song, but the people want it, so it get away. So Copper Shot burst now. So Jammies never really tell me what the vice again, because the first time he object to one of my songs, it's a bomb. And from I do Copper Shot, that was where my success start from.
What's the best part about being successful and being a star to you?
Well, the best part of being successful and being a star is to know that so many people in the world loves you and look up to you as a role model. And the best thing is to know that you are reaching somewhere that you look forward to a long time, and it's happening. And as me being a star now, the greatest thing is to know that I had the full rights of my career and I have control over it. Because now is a dangerous time with artists and career and management.
Yeah.
It's going out of proportion. If you don't know one slip, and I'm not going to try to be around for the next 20 years to gain what I should have. No, I'm going to stick out for that. No.
Right. All right. Well, let's play one of your videos then.
Oh, well, let's go to the Benz and Bimmer. Not the most currently one, but it's recent. We just take from the My Experience album. And it's a bomb. Check it out.
The winner of all the competitions and stuff. Is that something you want to continue doing, or?
No, we ain't gonna continue that, cause I didn't pursue all of that. That just came from out of nowhere and it blew out of proportion. But you know, we got it stabilized now and we had it in control and everything is nice now. No rivalry. We and Beanie Man is friends. He's even on the My Experience album. We're
able
to perform, we do things together, and it's just niceness. You understand?
Yeah.
So competition isn't the thing for the music, because we can't be competing with our reggae music or no music. We must combine and collaborate all music and make more music and good music as much. You understand? So competition isn't my thing.
Right. It doesn't have to be one person on top. It can be a lot of people doing well.
Everyone just do their little thing and we all go home and sing.
All right. We'll be right back with more Caribbean Rhythms with Bounty Killer.
Now number.
Michelle, and I'm here with Baltic Killer in Jamaica. Good to have you on the show.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to be here.
My Experience album, your US debut album. You collaborated with a lot of different people on it, a lot of hip hoppers in the producing and in the artists on the album.
Yeah, well,
how did that come about and why did you do that, you know?
Oh, well, it's a scare them idea. And I just want to get this across in the music industry. That's our album becomes a bomb. You got to use a whole collaboration of people. You can't just go with just your ideas. Because I'm influenced to use violin. And that guy influenced to use the synthesizer. So you get a little synthesizer, a little violin, a little piano, and put them together, you got a bomb music. So that's why I said, okay, if I use a little Fugees, a little Buster, a little Eric Sermon, a little Beanie Man, a little Barrington Levy, a little Richard Steven, a little Junior Reed, and me, myself, Bounty Killer, they had half of the reggae industry. That's gonna be a total nuclear bomb.
What do you think about it, though, in terms of keeping the music authentic? You know, because when you mix it together, sometimes you lose the authentic.
Well, I just want to tell them this. My album, My Experience, is consists of 20 tracks. And it got 4 hardcore hip-hop tracks, but it got 16 authentic reggae tracks. And it takes 14 songs to make an album. And it had 16 authentic reggae songs.
Why put 20 songs on the album?
I just want to show them that's Bounty Killer. I'm a man with enough energy and a lot of deliverance. So whenever I give people, it's like when I was in New York, I told them that New York is so nice. When I'm in New York, it's like the response is twice, like New York, New York. So I give them it twice, Yeah, something like that.
So you've changed your whole vibe with this album, though. It's not so much, and more recently too, with, you know, you're moving away from speaking about a lot of, you know, the violence or the gangster stuff. Now you're singing about love and God and, you know, the woman, more of that kind of thing. Why you change your whole vibe?
It's like when I first came, I did a song called The Gunning Must Done, and that song never get its right. So it was like me, you know, I just need some success. I was trying all type of things. So I said, I did that and it never worked. I'm suffering and I need to get out of this poverty and suffering and stress. Copper shot. Because I said, leave the guns, and it never went anywhere. So I said, take up the gun. And so foolish, the people them supported. So that made me thought that was the right thing. But when I came to Stardom, no, people started to talk against it and said, no, Bounty Killer, you're a role model. We have kids who look up to you and whatever. And I start looking to myself and said, no, I mean more than that. And now I'm at Stardom. I don't have to talk about guns, but I thought I did have to do in the first. But now I realize, no, it's what you present to the people. They accept.
Right. You've been given the title of poor man's governor.
It's because now Bounty Killer, I come from the authentic ghetto. I was born in Kingston 13 in a place called, they call it Ghost Town. We from the ghetto, we face a lot of political stress and issue. And when I came to Stardom, I think it's right to go back and chant and remind them what is happening back in the ghetto. So I always DJ about down in the ghetto and poor people suffering. And so people always say, okay, Bounty Killer is the poor people governor, because I always try to talk about the poor people.
Right.
While I could be talking about girls and guns and, you understand? So they said, you are the poor people governor. So I said, okay, I'm thankful for that. So I'm going to defend the poor to the end.
Right, with your song Fed Up, one of the political parties in Jamaica wanted to use the song Fed Up for their campaign song, and you didn't want them to use it. What was that?
Yeah, I object to that because that's not right. That song was made for the country. The people who think that they are the rights of speaking out, that it's freedom of speech. We ain't comfortable with this and we're fed up of that. And it was made for the public and not no particular political party. Okay, let it stay neutral. Anybody could use it, but no political party. Make it stay for the public. That was made for the poor. You understand? And maybe they are fed up of you too. So,
right.
We are fed up of all evilest politicians, because they are good politicians. Because we have bad politicians. If you don't have no politicians, the country can't run.
That was a good decision. Stay neutral.
Make it neutral.
All right, well, let's play another Bounty song on Corbin.
Yeah, because you know we had a lot. And a lot to come.
Go on, baby.
Oh, well, this one is changed like the weather. Bounty Killer and Junior Reed and Busta Rhymes. Check it. Let's kick it.
This music block is brought to you by Pepsi, who invites you to join Generation Next.
A lot of crazy weather on the map today. We've sent our correspondents out. We have Bounty Killer, Busta Rhymes, and Junior Reed on location. And Bounty right now is in the center of a stagnant high-pressure system, and it must